Hello, and welcome to Twilight Thoughts. My name is Bryce, and I'll be your host for today. We'll begin in a moment, but first I'd like to let you know that soon you will be entertained by news, reports, scandal, and of course, speculation. Bryce the Tower, we are ready for takeoff. Hey guys, this is Bryce, and I am here today with my buddy James. What's going on, man? How are you?
Good evening, everyone. I hope you're all having a wonderful time at home.
Now, people who are used to listening to this show, you know that Twilight Thoughts are usually just me and my lonesome self. But tonight, something has happened. Something that has been going around the internet that I really wanted to talk about. And I wanted to get James' opinion on it, so I have brought him in, and we are going to discuss the fact that there's a headline going around saying that Bob Iger is returning to Disney. Now, James, what do you feel about this?
I feel like for the sake of that company not completely closing up shop, it was a necessary move, and although he had the best intentions of leaving at the very top of his reign, I'm sure he's been grooming Bob Chapek for quite some time. I don't think a lot of people like Bob Chapek, but at the same time, I kind of feel bad for the guy because he was somewhat thrown to the wolves. So my biggest thing is, you know, I don't want the company to fail. I really don't. And I don't want Bob Chapek to fail. I know I'd probably said some unkind things about him, but after listening to Bob Iger's book all the way through start to finish, I come to the realization Bob Chapek's definitely been a key person to help Bob Iger with things behind the scenes that people don't know about. So, you know, I don't think he's a bad guy or something like that. But right. he's made some decisions with cutting costs where I feel like they could cut costs in different areas, eliminating certain cast member positions. Where with entertainment, I don't think that's going to be top of people's list of things to cut. You know, he just seems to, you know, lop the heads off of the entertainment that people love. I know that a lot of the entertainment that was canceled in Epcot will come back. It's not like they're never going to have the drumming team or whatever the heck they're called in Japan. I know they'll probably bring that back. I mean, it's part of their culture. They've been doing it for 30 years, so
sure.
Do you feel the same way, or is it a little bit different?
Okay, so one thing that I've always tried to do, and I am going to get better at this, I swear, is check sources, and not only just check sources, but bring up sources on the show as I talk about them. Because here's the deal. The first time I saw this headline was from another podcast's website, right? Which, there is nothing wrong with that. There is, you know, there's a fine chance that what they are saying is actually correct. The problem is that this is such a fantastical headline, right? That it just didn't seem real to me. So I did a little bit of digging, and it ended up coming from the New York Times. So it's got some clout behind it. You know what I'm saying? Like you can say what they're reporting on is most likely going to be factual, right?
Exactly.
So I read the article, and nowhere in the article does it say that Bob Iger is taking over for Bob Chapek. Now, I do think that for the time being, Bob Iger is going to be, let's say, the face of the company.
Yeah.
Where he is going to go out and talk to investors. He is going to go out and talk to stockholders. He is going to make appearances on television shows, whatever he's got to do to keep people from knowing, hey, the kingdom is burning, right? He has to play the Nero. So I think that is what is going to happen. But meanwhile, as Bob Iger is doing that, Bob Chapek is still going to be making the decisions. You know what I'm saying? Because here's the thing. Bob Iger has been around for so long. He's been 15, 16 years now as the CEO. Exactly. So it's familiarity. People want familiarity. And right now, quite honestly, nobody trusts Bob Chapek. And that's for better or for worse, but they have no reason to trust Bob Chapek. They really have no reason to mistrust him, but they also have no history there. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. They have nothing there to be like, okay, I know what you're saying is accurate. I know what you're saying is true. I have every faith that you are going to take this company where it needs to go to land on its feet. And I think that that is what Bob Iger brings to the situation, where he goes, yeah, I'm going to go out and tell the stockholders exactly what you want me to say, but it's going to go over so much better because it's coming from me. The person that they've seen has this 15-year history building up to this one point. And real quick, let's just talk about the storm that Bob Chapek got dropped into. I mean, being named the CEO of Disney when you've worked at Disney your entire life, dude, that's a dream.
Yeah.
That's the dream. That is the tip of the mountain, right? And the first week he is there, Haunted Mansion breaks down, Jungle Cruise sinks, the Transit Authority crashes in to itself, the Haunted Mansion goes down again, and then the coronavirus hits, and everything shuts down. He was named the CEO at the beginning of February, and then at the end of March, the coronavirus came in and said, you know what? We're closing everything. No one's doing anything. And now here we are. Or, I'm sorry, not even the end of March. It was the middle of March. So he has had no time to build any kind of history. This has been a complete nightmare for him. And so I think Bob Iger lending him a hand and saying, hey, look, this is clearly a terrible time. This is extraordinary circumstances. Let me give you a hand. Let me help you. Let me be that face to calm the stockholders. You know what I'm saying? So, James, what is your opinion, man? Do you think that Bob Iger is kind of staging a little hostile takeover coup style, or is he going in and saying, hey, I'm here to help?
No. Because I literally just finished his book on Friday, I really do feel like he's going in there to help, because he's a fan of Disney just like the rest of us. I mean, he used to go there when he was younger and stuff like that. I mean, he'd go to Disneyland and stuff like that. So he never thought in a million years he'd be the CEO of that company. But it's just like, you know, he's always respected Disney. So, no, he doesn't want it to fail. And he has so much stake in that company. It's like, why would you want your life's work to just crumble as soon as you leave? No, of course you'd want it to flourish. And I think he's like, look, I've been in the same spot as you. Right. Obviously not with a virus. But, you know, he's probably going to help Bob Chapek and be like, hey, look, don't worry about this. It's kind of like the Frank Wells, Michael Eisner, you know, you need a good solid partner to get you through something this crazy. So he's probably just going to be like, look, instead of just cutting all these jobs, try doing this. Instead of staying closed until September, try opening on this date, you know, talk to the shareholders, that kind of thing. Because he knows how to handle shareholders. He knows how to handle different countries. He knows different languages. I mean, he's got some serious talent. So
what do you think then of all of like the furloughs that are happening right now? Because Disney furloughed 30,000 workers in California and 43,000 workers in Florida. Now, if you don't know what furlough means, it means that everything just kind of freezes. They're not fired. These employees still have their jobs. Their cast members still have their jobs waiting for them. But Disney has no means of paying them, because Disney is not bringing in any type of money. So all of their benefits are frozen. Yeah. Everything is frozen in place.
Thanks, Elsa.
Touché, sir. Gotta love a good pun. Then the other thing that they were saying is that, and I, by they, I mean this New York Times article, is that Bob Iger said that there was going to be a reopening with fewer employees. That's what his view of the future of the Disney resort was. Fewer employees. Well, Iger said in an email on Sunday evening that he had, quote, no recollection of ever having said that he expected a smaller workforce. Then he goes on to say, regardless, any decision about staff reductions will be made by my successor and not me, which just goes to the point of he's here to help. He's not here taking things over, because even at this point, he is still looking to Chapek. He is still being subordinate to him. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I don't know, man. It's just a crazy, crazy situation that we all find ourselves in with this coronavirus. You know, we have not been really addressing it because we've been doing the trivia thing, so we're not even worried about the weekly news and whatnot right now. But this came out, and like, we should probably talk about this. This deserves a very quick,
it's a big deal.
Exactly.
It's very rare that a CEO comes back. I mean, the same thing kind of happened to Steve Jobs with Apple, so it's not like it's never happened before.
Exactly. So it'll be interesting to see what comes of this. My question really is, I don't care who's running the company. I just want to know when the parks are going to be open again, because they keep getting pushed, right? Like, the first closure was 2 weeks away, and then, okay, it's not April. We're going to open April 15th. And not April 15th. Now it's the beginning of June. So I want to know how far that keeps going. And see, the other thing that's interesting is that Bob Iger, while he was running Disney, I think there was 1 or 2 days that the parks closed down because of hurricanes or whatever. And Bob Chapek comes in and he has to deal with the virus that is closing down not just Orlando. It's closing down all of the parks all across the world, where they're not running for months on end. It's going to be really interesting to see where Disney stands after the dust settles on all of this. I mean, big companies are closing. AMC just filed bankruptcy. It's not saying that it's never going to come back. You know what I'm saying? Like, oh, you know, we get out of the coronavirus, AMC is gone for good. It might mean that, but there is a possibility that AMC could work back from that. So maybe that's what Disney does. I mean, Bob Iger has furloughed himself. He has furloughed Chapek. So they're not even free of these ill effects. You know what I'm saying? All right, James, let me ask you this one quick question and then we will say goodbye. But where do you think, when all of this is said and done, the Disney company will stand?
Personally, I think they're going to, it's going to be really long, hard road until they can get back to where they were. I don't think it's ever going to be exactly where it was in the past. I think they're going to have some serious obstacles of monitoring people coming in and out of the parks. There's some interesting software that's available that a lot of police officers are utilizing, but they'll be utilizing it most likely in the parks. It'll be able to monitor people's temperatures. So instead of just walking up to someone saying, hey, I need to check your temperature, they'll be able to monitor, you know, 20, 30 guests at a time and say, hey, homeboy walking up here in the green shirt's got a temperature of 102. He needs to step out of line.
Right.
So they're going to have to monitor that, because having everyone stand in a line and get their temperature read by a little, even if it's by a gun, is going to slow down that experience. If it takes you an extra hour to get into the parks, it ain't going to fly with a lot of people.
Sure.
So I think the day that it opens is going to be so jam-packed with people, and they're going to be like, yeah, we can't have any more people here. And they're going to try to soft open it and only have a couple things open, not everything. And then as time progresses, I think they're going to unlock more features in the park and stuff. But I don't think they're going to have every single park open the same day. I think they're going to open Magic Kingdom, then they'll open, like, you know, Epcot, and then Animal Kingdom and Hollywood Studios. I don't think they're going to have all four of them just go balls to the wall in the beginning. So
I agree with you on every point, aside from the fact that the crowds are going to pack out the parks. I don't think that they will. I really don't think that they will, because I feel like even though the government will go, oh yeah, you know what, it's safe, you're fine, go ahead, I do feel like people are going to be, you know, somewhat cautious. I feel like they're
absolutely
not going to want
to. You have to be.
Exactly. I don't think they're going to want to go out to the parks. I don't think they're going to want to have that very close interaction that you just, it comes naturally from being in the parks. I mean, watch any fireworks show and you are stood shoulder to shoulder with a person on your left and on your right. You can't go anywhere. It's kind of amazing how many people they cram in those parks. So I don't think they're going to pack out the parks, because people will see that, they'll know that and go, ah, you know what? Maybe I wait. The other thing is, I think they are going to cut back on accessibility. I don't think they're going to say, hey, you know what? Our capacity is, let's say, 10,000 people in Magic Kingdom, which I think that is the case. Maybe it's more. I don't know. But let's call it just 10,000 people. They'll say, you know what? We're not going to have 10,000 people. Our capacity is only going to be 5,000 people or 3,000 people, possibly. I don't know, but I think that's what they're going to do. It's going to be really interesting to see what shakes out of all this. I'm really, really interested. And with that, guys, thank you very much for listening. What do you think of all of this? Where do you think the Disney parks are going to stand when all of this ends and the parks reopen and we're able to go back to the movie theaters? Because they're losing a bunch of money at the theaters. They are losing a bunch of money at the theaters. It's sad, almost, for them, you know? But guys, let me know your thoughts. In the meantime, you can find me on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. On Facebook, just search the Nocturnal Disney Podcast and search our little group. On Twitter, it's at Disney Nocturnal. And on Instagram, it's at the Nocturnal Disney Podcast, all separated by underscores. James, where can people find you, man?
If you go onto iFunny, I have the Game of Thrones and the Walt Disney accounts.
Very nice. Very nice. All right, guys. Well, thank you very much for listening. And
on behalf of our entire crew, thanks for soaring with us. And have a great day wherever your final destination may take you.